Hello everybody and welcome to my ranked season 8 tier 4 Jaguar Destroyer Advanced Tactics video. What a long name. We are going to play the Jaguar with Mr. Obeno. Mr. Obeno will be inspired by a 16/4, so maxed out bay, giving 6% advanced concealment, and a 16/3 together with those two, we are using in the second perk the speed concealment, which means while the speed boost is active, the concealment will drop a further 20%. And that will give you 4.1 kilometer concealment while the speed boost is active. You have like two and a half minutes roughly for the first speed boost, while your concealment is 4.1 kilometer. And the essence of playing the Jaguar in ranked is to make use of this super concealment, because you can outspot every other destroyer in tier 4, even a kamikaze, which can at best get 4.3 kilometer, which is 200 less than you can get on the Jaguar. Having said that, let's get started. A lot of people have said before the season, let's take the Farragut, is the OP destroyer because of his guns, and he will gun anybody down. So you will see in the coming games, which are my track from rank 3 to rank 1, I engaged a lot of Farraguts, and you will see how I deal with the Farraguts. So what do I do here in this game is a very risky move. We make use of the advanced speed, because the Jaguar is faster than any other destroyer, about 10% faster, so we can reach this position before the enemy does. And what we do here with our super concealment of 4.1 kilometer, we're just dropping the torps before the Farragut even does know we are around here, because he expects us on the other side. So his guns are pointing to the wrong direction, our torpedoes are in the water, and he is being shot by our team while we are covered behind the island. And we're moving, and there's another destroyer. Unfortunately, we just released the torpedoes, so we have to fight him with guns only. Let's get some shots out on him and see how things develop. So while the destroyer is smoked up, of course we're not engaging him due to the support he gets from his other battleships. We make use of our speed to get away from here and circling around this area to continue the fight from a different position. So now we're spotted because our super concealment is gone. We have 5.1 kilometer concealment. So now we have to engage. And we put our destroyer in a position where we're not broadsiding the other red ships. And we keep shooting the Minekaze. Hoping our team is going to assist. And as you can see, I sort of kite the incoming fires, turning out, shooting with three guns only, sometimes five. It's not necessary you use all five guns all the time. It's more important you avoid incoming fire. Even you got 16k HP, but you want to destroy more than one destroyer. So we need to survive this fight with as much HP as possible. And as you can see, we have been hit hard. So survival is barely possible with this fire burning. So we did our job here, and the team does the rest. In the second game, we kept C, but instead of going further left outside around the island, again, I'm taking a risky move now, making use of my super concealment, not yet active, but I'm waiting for the cap to be finished because this is the most important. And then we are heading straight forward in. It's a more rare move. Most people either stay in their cap or move outside. Only few people take the middle because usually in the middle you die fast. We will see how things develop here. Soon I'm gonna be spotted by Farragut again. And we will see how I do this time against the Farragut. The Farragut is supported by a cruiser behind an island. And let's see how you can deal with the two of them. It's gonna be a very fast-paced action. And you will soon see the moves. The basic idea is always to show as little broadside to the enemy as possible to prevent the enemy from torping you, at the same time get your torps into the water. So I'm using widespread here, a little bit next to each other, because the Farragut obviously is coming for me and he wants to gun me down because he thinks he has the better guns. He made the mistake to turn left and then right again, so he's gone now. And then we have the cruiser. So what can we do now? The cruiser is 2 kilometers. We can move out, but that doesn't make sense. So I switch to AP and attack the cruiser with AP, hoping for some citadels. And the cruiser is aiming at me. That gives my team time to approach the cruiser at the same time, and we keep him busy, taking cover from the island, going around the island, and coming back from the other side. Game number 3 is similar to the first game, but this time we're staying on the outside, going around. And as you can see, we're detected, so the Farragut is probably around, and we expect him to show up pretty soon. And you have to watch the minimap what your team is doing, so you can see we have our own Farragut following me. Unfortunately, the Farragut is a little bit too defensive and too far outside during the whole game. You will see that soon. We could have finished the enemy much earlier, so I take the major load to kill the Farragut here. But okay, that is how it goes. So first we drop the torpedoes, then we start shooting because we want to distract the enemy hovering around our torpedoes. And then we turn out a little bit, so the broadside is getting smaller, preventing more fire from the red team. So just the Farragut is able to shoot at us, and we keep gunning. We play with the course, with the speed, and finally we finish him. So we're using the damage control to get away as fast as possible because the Jaguar is over there. He is damaged, but as you know from my own Jaguar, the Jaguar is a big threat with his 5 guns, 2k each, so one hit and I'm dead. So that's why I'm moving out and I'm asking my Farragut colleague, who is almost full health, to go in and spot. Unfortunately, he's pretty reluctant to do so, which is not a very good destroyer play. He expect me to spot, being low health, but okay, again, I have to get around this. So I'm staying outside and wait till he moves in to support him later on. Because a dead destroyer can't help the team, so you have to stay alive. That's the most important part. Because alive means you can shoot. At the moment we are behind in caps. So we have to make sure we get some caps. We're leading in ships, we're leading in destroyers, which is very important. But still we need to get the cap. So that's why there's no way around, we have to get the sea cap. Unfortunately the Jaguar is too far out. I would have opened up if he was within 9 kilometers, but I can't reach him. So we continue the travel to sea. And with the smoke, of course, we drop the torpedoes to force the destroyer out of the smoke. And now we cannot open on the destroyer because our health is too low. So we have to wait till the Farragut got 2 or 3 hits on the destroyer, because after 2 salvos, we probably will be dead. So we have to make sure we hit with these 2 salvos and assist, but we won't be the first to open up. Meanwhile, you can see B is contested, and now our own DD is capping B, and if we get rid of this Japanese DD, we're gonna cap C as well. So it's all about capping in the end. Most of the games, you either win by caps or by kills, but leading in caps allows you to play more defensive and reactive. You don't have to be too pushy, and pushy is always more risky. So it's always good if you lead in points, because then you can decide what's the next move. Do you want to move out, or do you want to move in? So finally we have the speed concealment back, so we can be more offensive now. 4.1 kilometer concealment, we're getting into position, we're turning around. And now we're reversing. Since everybody is shooting the Japanese DD, of course we add to that. The next game, not much has happened in the first half of the game. We have received all 3 caps. I landed the torpedo, but now the game really starts with the fight between the Acasta and myself. Because you will see we're gonna meet the Acasta over and over again. And this is gonna be a pretty close game in the end, even it doesn't look like it right now. So what I'm doing here is I'm turning my body away from the enemy fire. To our left is a battleship, so we have to make sure it can't hit us. So we're not spotted anymore due to the Acasta smoking up. Now we turn into his torpedo drop direction at the same time we dropped our own. So what we want to do is here to get into the smoke and use the smoke by ourselves, and use the time to turn the turrets. As you might know, the French have pretty slow turn rate for the turrets, so you have to prepare your ambush. And I expect the Acasta to on my left. Now I'm putting the speed concealment on in case the Acasta is further out than 4 kilometers. But unfortunately he is not, that's why he spotted me. So we're gonna open up again with the guns in good position. And of course he's smoking again. But he doesn't have any more support left. All his ships are far out, so basically it's between the Acasta and the Jaguar. And now I'm turning left again, because I expect some torpedoes to arrive soon. So I want to make sure I'm correctly positioned, and I don't want to go too far out. There's no sense in pursuing the Acasta at the moment. I have to go back to support capping A and C, because we lost one cap already, and the enemy has 3 DDs left, so pretty likely they're gonna cap more, so I have to assist my own 2 DDs defend the cap. So that's why I decided to turn left now and go back. And again, there was another DD trade. So you can see the red team is capping A as well. So if we don't prevent the A cap, and if we don't keep the A cap, we're gonna lose the game by points. So now you can see my speed concealment quickly showed the Acasta. I have the advantage to drop some torps. I get into position and then I fire, because I get out almost 2 salvos before the first hits me. And that way I can further reduce his HP. I'm not repairing my torpedo tube right now, because I need it for against fire or rudder or engine broken. Torpedoes are not a major issue right now. So again, the Acasta smoked up a last salvo, but then I have to proceed into A, because A is still being kept and my blue DD is trying to get this Farragut, and I have to assist the Farragut. That's more important now. So that's why I'm turning and start shooting. And we got it. So next move is we have to recap A. I could go for the Acasta, but there is a chance he hits me with a torpedo or with a gun, and my destroyer will be lost, and he might also kill my second destroyer. So there's no need to take this risk. It's much safer to get the A cap and then proceed to the C cap. If we get A and C after, the Acasta can't cap as fast as we can do with 2 destroyers. So that's why I'm going the safe way, because it's all about winning. It's not about kills. It's not about having the maximum damage. It's just getting through this grind of campaign by winning game by game. Still, I'm dropping some torpedoes for distraction, because I expect the Acasta to move into the cap pretty soon. And that's why I'm telling my friendly DD to go to C-cap. I will follow, but I'm ready to shoot the Acasta as soon as he enters the cap. And you can see I'm spotted, so I have to turn, because he for sure is going to shoot at me now. There are the shots, and here we go. Next game is a 5v5 game, and in a game with less players it's even more important every individual player performs and you don't take unnecessary risk. That's why I'm staying in my cap, make sure we get the cap and prepare myself for any destroyer coming around. And of course there is the Farragut, so immediately I have to open the fire because I know there's a DD next to me and I got some support, so good chance we're gonna bring down the Farragut. Lucky for me, my own DD smoked up a bit, so that's why I'm slowing down, make use of the smoke. But I need a spotter, of course, and that's the difficult part here. So finally the Farragut smoked up and there's just one choice. I have to spot him and to bring him down because he's a major threat with his guns and I'm full health, so there's no risk to go in and spot him and kill him with the support of my other destroyer. But before I go in, of course I drop some torpedoes into the smoke. If he moved out, there's no loss. If he stays in, I might get a hit or a distraction at least, while I'm narrowing the 2 km spotting range. There he is. Goodbye. And now the next important thing is to finish the cap, because B has already been capped by the red team, so we don't want to lose too many points. And now you can have a look at the minimap and see the last position markers. There is a cruiser marked and you see where the battleships are. So we're trying to get to the cruiser and let's see how things develop. The Omaha is an easy to citadel cruiser. If you can get into 3 km or less to his broadside, it may torp you, but if you shoot AP with the Jaguar, you get a citadel with every single bullet. So you can easily get 10 citadels on the Omaha. And it's worth sneaking up because the HP pool of Omaha isn't that large. If you're full health in Jaguar and if you're fast, a little surprise attack, you can approach the Omaha and gun it down. Lucky for me, I don't have to move that far because the Omaha is gonna die by my team. So now there's one DD and 2 battleships left, and still I'm spotted by this annoying plane. But I'm gonna move in into the B cap because we need to put pressure on the cap points. We are leading in points, but we want to increase the pressure and at the same time get into position to the battleships. But with this plane on my head, I'm trying to stay behind that island until I gun down the plane with my anti-aircraft, which takes a while because the destroyers have very limited anti-aircraft. So I have to be nose into the battleships, and you can see obviously the destroyer isn't far out. So I'm planning to stay left of the island to be covered from the battleships while I'm spotted and make sure the plane is gone. Unfortunately the destroyer is in the smoke, can shoot me because I'm spotted. So I have to rush behind the island. Now I'm slowing down and have to make sure that I get rid of the plane. And since the plane moves out, I decided to move on again. The DD is to my right. And we have to see if we can locate him. At the moment we don't have the super concealment, so we have to stay away. He will outspot us. But again, there's no pressure. It's five versus two. We're leading in points, we're leading in ships, so we can play this more defensively and just enter the cap, block their points. And as you can see, I just did 7,600 damage so far. It's not pretty much, but we got one cap already. Now the destroyer leaves the cap, so while shooting at him, we're also starting to cap. So I'm slowing down now because I want to get the cap. And then I'm turning right because the battleship is moving to the right. And if my team is not going to kill the battleship, I'm going to torp it. At the same time, turning my guns to the left, prepare to shoot the enemy destroyer with my left side. So we have a solo cap on top, which adds very nicely to XP earned. And there it is, we are well prepared. Again, you don't need twist and track. If you know a little bit about destroyer play and what they do, what they want to do, you can guess where they're going to be and you just kill them. Next game on the road to rank 1 is a pretty fast-paced battle between myself and an enemy T-22 and those two cruisers you see, because of course I have to battle ACAP and I get some support from the DD following me, but I say some because he's staying in the back very far out, but at least he unleashes some torpedoes for destruction, and this is pretty helpful at the opening of the battle because you can see the T-22 is incoming. And again, super concealment active, 4.1 kilometers, so I can choose my fight, I can choose my position, and I make sure my torpedoes are ready before I shoot. So I want to get out the torpedoes early on, see how the enemy moves. You can see the 22 moves out, but he moves in again, so I'm using the widespread for maximum destruction, not really to kill him with torpedoes, but to tell him torpedoes are in the water. And now I'm opening because there's an island in front of me and I'm planning to get 2-3 salvos out and then hide behind the island. Obviously those two cruisers are a major threat. If they start to aim at me, I'm dead pretty fast. But lucky for me, my torpedoes will have a good effect and we're gonna kill the cruiser, and now we aim at the T-22. And as you can see, the second DD is a little bit too far out. He needs to be further in with his good concealment. It's a Japanese DD. But it doesn't matter. We focus on the T-22. We have to bring down the destroyer before the cruiser, because the destroyers are the major threat here. And then we deal with the cruiser and see how much we can do there. But if we can bring down two destroyers, that's a good trade. One versus two. Job done. So unfortunately, I'm too slow to get away because the Emil is heading my direction. He doesn't have to turn, so he's coming full speed in. I'm just trying to get some torps into the water and then he's going to shred me. And I'm trying to get some AP loaded in case he is trying to broadside, but he's clever playing and coming nose in, so my AP doesn't do damage at the moment. So this is clear, I'm gonna die here now. But again, you can see the enemy consists only of two ships, so it doesn't matter. We kept the cruiser far away from the other points of the caps, and he doesn't play a role in this game anymore. And that's why we're gonna win this game. Next game is a fast destroyer game. We're gonna face a Farragut again. After having received the cap on C, we spot the Farragut, but he doesn't spot me. So I'm getting into position, get my torps into the water before he can spot me. And then we open up the fire. And he can't torp me at the moment because he's busy smoking up. He can't torp forward while he's being confronted with my torps. And then there's a second DD. So what can we do? I'm trying to spot the Farragut now because my team can only shoot what they see. So I have to get within 2 kilometers, but lucky for me, my torpedoes hit. And now we can deal with the 22. Same here, slow down, avoid the torpedoes. And then I have to spot him. He doesn't see anything as well, but I have to close the distance 2 kilometers or less to spot him in the smoke. And then I'm gonna move out to the right while my team can shoot at him. And if I have to get around the island, he is in crossfire from both sides and he can't have the guns to both sides. So that's why I'm moving around the island while I spot him. But unfortunately I beached here, so everything on reverse and I keep shooting him altogether. And then forward again in case he puts some torpedoes in the water, we don't want to eat them. And that was a quick decision of this game, because 2 DDs down, no ship lost, a third one on the other cap. And now we help with the cruiser. And then the game is over already. Finally, the last game to rank 1. Standard game, standard positioning, we're moving to A with super concealment, so we can outspot the enemy DDs capping A. And of course there is again an infamous Farragut and a kamikaze we're gonna engage. And in front of us is a destroyer dropping torps to the most common route. You see that island at 3 o'clock in A. Every destroyer is coming around that corner while he's capping, so you drop torps into that direction and with somewhat narrowed angle, and sometimes you get lucky. I got a hit there every second game, so it's pretty common, like you see here, to drop some torps. But I don't have to drop my torps here because torps are in the water already, so I keep mine and be ready to drop them on any spotted destroyer. Again, I'm located. You can see that location icon, that arrow. That means probably the Farragut is here. And of course, I'm gonna spot him right now. And I'm gonna drop my torpedoes as always, one on his route and one on his slowdown pass, because it was obvious he's going to smoke up. We open up because we have a support DD and another ship with us, and plan is to bring him down ASAP. And now we need to spot him. That's why I'm turning to the right, and again there is a cruiser to my left. Oh, lucky me, I hit him with a torpedo, but we cannot engage the Emil. We want to get the island between the Emil and us, and at the same time shoot the kamikaze, turn the guns to the left side, because we're going to make a right turn. So the Emil has only our back, and we turn the broadside to the kamikaze, get 5 guns on the kamikaze. And we need to bring it down, keep it spotted, that's another big threat. So if we can trade 2 DDs, that was a great game again. And again, the Kami has torps in the water for us, so it's gonna be a trade, but it's a 2v1, and job done. The rest is up to the team, and if you lead with your team 2D Destroyer versus 1, the game is 90% won. I hope I provided you some useful tactical feedback of how you can survive ranked. Again, my recommendation is the Jaguar if you're somewhat comfortable in destroyers, because it's the most versatile ship. Huge HP, huge guns, hard-hitting torpedoes, fastest ship and best concealment with speed boost. Thank you very much. Hit the thumbs up, join my channel, and good luck for your own ranked season. See you out there in Standard again.